When choosing your solar mounting system, you want to make sure that it lasts, especially when a metal roof's lifespan is over 50 years. This is why it's important to use a mounting system that won't damage your roof. When deciding which long-lasting method to use, it is important to look at a number of factors. First, you need to know how you're going to attach the modules to your roof. Are you going to use this rail system or a direct attach system? Second, most people want to know how they can save money, right? Well, today we're going to show you how you can save 50% on your mounting costs. We'll break down an actual project comparing the two mounting systems. Additionally, we'll go over a number of categories to help you determine which system is the right for your project. At the end of this video, you'll be able to download the checklist to use on your next project. Hello, I'm Sean Haddock with S5. As we get started, I want to point out that metal roofs offer advantages over other roofing types. They outlast the life of the PV system, they're easier to mount to, and when they're standing seam, there are no penetrations, and when using the proper attachment solutions, they come with free rails. This is a built-in structural free rail. Railless mounting means that you shift your thinking, and instead of adding rails to a system, you go with a direct attach. You're using the roof or the ribs of the roof for a rail-free mounting. Here are five things to consider that we cover in this video. Design, aesthetics, logistics, installation, and finally, cost. The first category we're going to discuss is design. And some of the questions you will need to ask yourself are, will you need to tilt your panels? Are there shaded spots you need to avoid? And what wind factors need to be considered? Can you install this system without damaging your roof and voiding any warranties? Do I need tilt on this system? Do I need to tilt my panels? And there's several reasons why you may or may not need to do this, one of which would be, how steep is the roof slope you're mounting to? Do you have good slope there where you don't need to tilt? Or would you need to use a tilting system like a racking system or a rail system that allows you to tilt? This can be done to achieve optimal direct sunlight as well as washing of the solar panels when it rains. When using a railless system or direct attach, you're limited to the slope of the roofs. Another thing to consider is your roof orientation and potential obstructions. These things can be trees, roof vents, roof piping, things that will put shade on your modules. With rail, you can often adjust and move away from those things, where with direct attach, you may have to move them to a different part of the roof or give some spacing to avoid that shading. Another item to consider under layout and design is module orientation, whether you're going to attach in portrait or in landscape. A lot of people are stuck on the portrait orientation because they want to put rails that run east and west. When with railless, you can mount with rails that already exist running north and south, and this would put you in the landscape orientation. So by mounting in portrait, you have the added rails, where mounting direct attach, you don't have the added rails since they're already on the roof as seams. So another item to consider is, what are the wind factors that you have to consider? And those are a little bit different in that some could be the area or the region you're attaching, such as coastal regions, but also on your roof and what wind zones you're attaching to. Are you able to avoid certain wind zones or do you need to attach in those zones? And that can be important because with rail, you can attach at every seam, but if you want to add more attachments from the module to the rail, you may need three or four rails to accommodate what you could do in landscape by attaching to every seam with a railless system. We briefly touched on wind loading, and another part of that is uniform load distribution. With a rail system, the way those are usually set up, you're not going to have as uniform a load distribution as you would with railless by attaching to the seams. Something that everyone should consider, wants to consider, and does consider is avoiding doing any damage to the roof and preserving all roof warranties. Both systems you can do this with. It's important to know what products you're using to attach to the roof, that they have round point set screws, things like that, to avoid any damage to the roof. Overall, railless takes this category. Now we're going to talk about aesthetics, how to choose a solar system design. A few things to keep in mind with aesthetics are, will this be a new construction or a retrofit? What are you doing for wire management? And what about module height? Are you installing on a new roof or retrofitting an old one? Both rail and railless can retrofit an old roof or install on a new roof. Concerns with wire management. Rail, you must pre-lay out your wires before you begin panel installation. Railless, you do the same thing, but there may be some time savings during the staging process because you can pre-lay out your wires and clip them to each module. So there's really no significant cost savings either way. Module height and performance. You want to make sure you have proper wind flow through and above your panels. In fact, too much heat on solar panels reduces their efficiency a lot more than cold temperatures. So having more efficient wind flow will actually help cool the modules. High-profile solar systems do not increase module performance. When you are figuring out the optimal airflow under your modules, it is important to realize that the temperature of the glass cell does not really decrease once the module is 4 inches above the roof. What this means is the module won't be any cooler regardless of how high you install it off the roof. With aesthetics, railless wins overall in this category. So let's talk a little about logistics and how you can lower shipping and handling costs for your solar project. For rail, first you pay the freight on it. It has to be trucked on a flatbed because of the length and weight. Not to mention that that length, if it's over 8 feet, can increase your surcharges. Then you unload it at the yard or your place of business because the job's not ready yet. Then you have to haul it to the job and risk possibly damaging it. How quickly can you replace those damaged products? Then you unload it by hand at the job site, and you may need to hire a crane or forklift. Then you lay it out and distribute it and start anchoring it with specialty clamps. You may also have to field cut at valleys and so on as mentioned above. Now let's talk about railless. First, you pay the freight on it. Not too much. It ships in about 3 days to wherever you want. It takes up to 2 or 3 cubic feet of space, including the clamps that you would have needed for the rail anyway. It gets delivered to your shop. Now the job is ready. Throw those boxes in the back of your pickup and drive to the job site. Then use a bucket to carry it up the ladder as well as your screw gun. With a railless system, your freight for a 4,000 square foot roof would require about 150 pounds of parts. Clamps and PV kits are a fraction of the weight and also a fraction of the space. Deliver them to your company or job site. There's ease of transportation with these products. No special equipment is needed. You can carry the clamps and direct attached components up the roof in a bucket. So with railless, your number of trips up and down a ladder to the job site, your handling of the materials is drastically eliminated. For logistics, railless takes this category. So the next thing we're going to be discussing is installation and how you can make your solar installation faster. Some things to consider when attaching rails are, will you need rail cutting equipment? If you're using rail, you might encounter sloped roofs with gables, valleys, and other obstructions that require field cutting and trimming to remove excess rail overhang. With railless, you don't need rail cutting equipment because you're using the standing seams on the roof, which are already pre-cut and pre-laid out. Next, do any of your parts come pre-assembled? Using rail, you'll have to buy all the components separately. You'll buy an individual rail, clamps, and required number of L-feet to attach the modules. But with railless or direct attached systems, these may come pre-assembled, so you can save time even before you go up on the roof. So under the installation category, railless wins. Now what you've been waiting for, cost. Do you want the best system that won't break the bank? Well, we'll show you an actual solar project and compare the cost between a railed system and a railless system. Let's look at the project specifications of an actual solar project. The roof size is 46 feet by 92 feet, with a total roof area of 4,232 square feet. The system size is 50 1/4 kilowatts. The module is an LG 335 watt. The dimensions of that module are 40 inches by 66.4 inches. We have a total of 150 modules with a seam spacing of 16 inches on the roof. The roof space utilization is 68%. For our specific project, here is an actual bill of materials for a railed and a direct attached system. As you can see, a more significant number of materials are required for railed systems than railless. We also surveyed installers who are familiar with both mounting methods, and they provided us with labor costs and installation time for both systems. They estimate that it would take 96 man hours to install the S5 clamps, L feet, and rails, including modules and torquing. This would be for two workers at $50 an hour, working for 6 days and 8 hours per day. This hourly rate is the contractor base cost plus payroll burden. When compared to railless, it is estimated that the same project might only take 67 man hours to install clamps with pre-assembled PV kits, including staging a material, installing modules, and torquing. With the same number of workers at $50 an hour, the project could be completed in approximately 4 days, 8 hours per day. Again, this hourly rate is the contractor base cost plus payroll burden. Project cost summary. Now that we have calculated labor cost, installation time, total cost of materials, and shipping, we can compare the entire installed cost of our project with both systems. Looking at the mounting system cost, the PV kit can save you 42%. So the total labor costs are $4,800 for rails and $3,350 for railless. That's a savings of 30%. One of the biggest savings between the two methods is with shipping. You can save about 61% with this project because railless parts will run you only $287 to ship at 149 pounds. Rails for this job will weigh 970 pounds and cost $733 to ship. The railed system for our project cost $10,973. The railless system cost is $6,783. Overall, this entire installed system will cost you about 38% less if you install direct attach. Our cost comparison shows that you can save almost 50% with your solar project when using a direct attach. An added benefit is that the PV kit provides more uniform load distribution and 25% more attachment points. So clearly, for this project, a railless system for mounting solar panels is the right way to go. These project quotes clearly show you the range of costs associated with both systems. With rails, you'll use less clamps, so you can save money there. But with direct attach, your overall weight of the system, often on the roof, and shipping of that weight is much less because there are no rails. So you save significantly more in that area. That is why it is so important to think of more than just the material costs. When you're choosing the right solar mounting system, you should always take into account whether you need to tilt your system, how you're going to manage material transportation, and if you need additional equipment for the installation, just to name a few. Remember, everything adds up. Time is money. Now that you've learned all the things to consider when deciding whether to use a direct attached solar system or a rail system, download our checklist in the description below and use it to find the right system for your next solar project.